Hey kids, once again it's Mr. Thaddaeus back with another awesome Bible lesson. Hope Christian Church. I hope you've had a great week. I've had a great week. So are you ready to go? Let's go. Let's get into today's lesson. Today's lesson is Shepherds Tell Others. Today's Bible scripture is Luke 2, 8 through 20. Today's Bible focus is we should tell others that Jesus is God's Son. In today's Bible memory verse is Luke chapter 2, verse 11. All right, before we get started, I need you to do three things really quickly. First thing I need you to do is, I need you to get rid of all your distractions. I need you to turn your TV off, I need you to put the dog out, I need you to put the cat out, I need you to turn your phone off, unless you're watching this lesson on your phone. The second thing I need you to do, I need you to tell everybody in your house, your brother, your sister, your father, your mother, grandmother, your grandfather, tell them, hey, Mr. Thaddaeus is back with another awesome Bible lesson, and I think you should listen to it. And the third thing I need you to do, I need you to get your Bible, because guess what? I have my Bible. So I'm going to give you 10 seconds to get your Bible. You ready? Let's go. Okay. You've got your Bible. Close your eyes and bow your head. Let's pray. Father God, we thank you for this time, Lord God, that you've given us, Lord God, to learn about you, Lord God, and learn about the lessons you've given us in the Bible, Lord God. Father God, I pray that you will open our eyes and open our hearts and open our ears to what you have to say, Lord God. And we pray that we would get what this lesson is trying to tell us, Lord God. In the name of Jesus, amen. Amen. Okay, so before we start today's lesson, there's something I want to talk about. And I want to talk about good news. Everybody loves good news. I love good news. You love good news. Everybody loves good news. So, what are different ways that you can share good news? First of all, what is good news? Good news is like a story or somebody telling you something that's good. It makes you happy or makes somebody else happy. And you want to tell somebody else. So what's good news? Good news is you got all A's on your report card. Good news is your best friend's coming over for a play date. Good news is that you're going to Six Flags or King's Dominion. That's good news. So what are different ways that you can tell people good news? Well, you can send a text. You can send an email. You can call somebody on the phone. You can write a letter. You can do all of that. Those are all different ways that you can tell people good news. So we should tell others that Jesus is God's Son. Guess what? That's good news. That's really good news. Let's find out what some shepherds did when they heard this good news. All right, so what I need you to do now, I need you to get your Bible, and I need you to turn to the book of Luke. Now, is the book of Luke in the Old Testament or the New Testament? If you think it's in the Old Testament, raise your right hand. If you think it's in the New Testament, raise your left hand. If you don't know what a testament is, raise both hands. Okay, the book of Luke is in the New Testament. Left hand people, way to go. Right hand people, better luck next time. And both hand people, a testament is just a book in the Bible. Okay, so let's turn to the book of Luke in the New Testament. I'm turning now. We're going to go to chapter 2. I'm going to read verse 8. So I want you to pay attention. I'm reading from the Message Bible, so my version may be slightly different than yours. Okay. Luke chapter 2, verse 8. There were two shepherds camping in a neighborhood. They had set night watches over their sheep. So, now, let's start the story. We talked about the shepherds on the hill looking over their sheep. Now, have any of you ever been on a hill or a mountain at night? I have. You know, what did you see? Well, what's there? Well, it's really dark. Probably in the country, in the woods, you're on this hill. It's really dark, you can't really see anything, but you see all the stars. on that night, for those shepherds in Luke chapter 2, Jesus was born. And those shepherds were out on a hillside in Bethlehem. They were taking care of their sheep. And then suddenly an angel sent from God appeared from the shepherds, and God's glory was shining around them. There's a big light, God's glory. And the shepherds were afraid. Would you be afraid? And one second, you're looking after your sheep, probably talking to your other shepherd friends, and next thing, this big light comes, and this angel appears. You'd be terrified. But the angel said, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people." And the shepherds were like, what good news? "Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord." Now that was good news. So the angel went on to tell the shepherds how they would know who the baby Jesus was. The angel said, "You will find the baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Good news. Suddenly, a large group of angels joined the first angel. And they began to praise God. And they said, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth, peace to those on whom his favor rests." That is great news. So the shepherds went from talking to each other to one angel showing up to now there's a host of angels, a lot of angels showing up singing to God. After they finished singing, all the angels left. Shepherds were by themselves again. The angel had told them that the Savior had been born in the city of David, which is another name of Bethlehem. And Bethlehem wasn't that far away. So the shepherds want to see what were the angels talking about? So they hurried to Bethlehem and found Mary, Joseph, and the baby Jesus, just like the angel said they would. The baby was lying in the manger, just as the angel said he would be. So do you know what the angels did after they saw the baby Jesus? What do you think they did? What would you do? They couldn't take a picture, post it on Instagram. Like, ever take a picture and post it, because that's what people do when they see stuff. The shepherds told others what they had heard and seen. They told others the good news. Everyone was amazed. Then the shepherds went back to the sheep, praising and thanking God. Okay, that's today's story. That's a great story. That's one of my top 10 Bible stories. Always love that story. Okay, so you've heard the story. I'm sure you paid attention. So now we're going to do our often imitated, seldom duplicated game called Amen and Uh-Uh. Well, I will tell you a Bible fact, a fact from this story. If this fact that I tell you is true, you'll say amen. If the fact I tell you is not true, you'll say all right, I hope you've been paying attention. First fact. On the night that Jesus was born, there were men in their garage fixing their cars. In this story, amen or uh-uh. That's not true. There were shepherds on a hillside watching their sheep. Okay, that was just a trick question. Here's the second one. Okay. The shepherd's on a hillside watching the sheep. An angel comes from the sky and says that, "Don't be afraid. I bring you good news that today the Savior has been born." Amen. Amen. That's true. That is true. That's what happened. So after that happened, angel went and told them. They said, "This is how you know who the baby Jesus is. If you go to the hospital and you go in the maternity ward and look through the glass, you'll see the little crib with the name Jesus on the crib, and that's how you know it's Jesus." Amen. That's not what he told them. The angel told them that you would know because you find the baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger. All right. Next one. After the angel said that, more angels came down and they start singing to God. Amen or uh-uh. Amen. That is true. That's true. Okay. So all the angels leave, the shepherds say, huh, that was weird. But they did talk about Jesus being born in Bethlehem, isn't that far away. We should go to Bethlehem. And then they decided, nah, I don't want to go to Bethlehem. Let's go to sleep. Amen or uh-uh. Mm-mm, that's not true. They decided to go to Bethlehem to see the baby Jesus. All right, here's the last one. The shepherds go to Bethlehem to see the baby Jesus. They get to Bethlehem. They look and find the baby Jesus lying in the manger, just as the angel said he would be. Amen. Amen. That's true. That's true. That's what happened. So, amen and uh-uh. You did a really good job. I thought I had you on the first one. Give yourself a round of applause. You did very good. Okay. So we did the story. We did amen and uh-uh. Now we have to do the Bible memory verse. Remember, I told you the Bible memory verse is Luke chapter 2, verse 11. So this is how we're going to do it. I'm going to read it. And I'm going to read a part. And you're going to say that part after me. And then we're going to read it together. So read, repeat, and then together. Okay. Luke chapter 2, verse 11. Let me read it first. Okay. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. All right, so I just read it. So I'm going to read a part, and you're going to repeat it after me. Okay, ready? Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. Very good. All right, let's say it together. You ready? One, two, three. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. Luke chapter 2, verse 11. Very good. All right. Now, I need you to bow your head, close your eyes, and let's pray. Let's pray on today's lesson. All right. Let's pray. Father God, we thank you for the lesson, Lord God, that you told us about the obedience of the shepherds who have to hear from the angel and all the other angels. They weren't scared, Lord God. They trusted in you. They wanted to see the Savior that had been born, Lord God. And we know because, Lord, you never lie. You said where the angel, where the Jesus would be, and Jesus was exactly where you said he would be, Lord God. So we went and told everybody the good news, Lord God. The shepherds told everybody the good news. So, Father God, we pray that you would give us a heart to tell everybody the good news about you, about your son that was born, Lord God, and died on the cross and was rose again for us, Lord God. So Father God, we thank you for this lesson, Lord God. In the name of Jesus we pray, amen. So that's today's lesson. Shepherds tell good news. There's good news to tell. Before we go, I need you to do three things. The first thing I need you to do, I need you to like this video, give this video a thumbs up, hearts, whatever they ask you to do, I need you to like this video. Second thing I need you to do, I need to share this video with at least three people. Ask your parents first. I know you know at least three people that would be blessed by this video if you share with them. The third thing I need you to do, I need you to tell somebody this week the good news about Jesus being born. Well, that's today's lesson. This is Mr. Thaddaeus from Hope Christian Church. I hope you enjoyed this lesson. I know I did. And I will see you next time. See you later.